What is the measure of my ministry? Welcome to Coffee with Pastor B. In the Bible that I read, the New American Standard Version, I actually read a study Bible version of that. I like it because at the beginning of each chapter, it has a heading information area. Now, in most Bibles, that's pre-filled out for you. But in this Bible, in the study Bible, they require you to go back and fill it out yourself. After you understand what the chapter means and what it's reading about, it's a great tool to have to allow me to go in and understand exactly what it's talking about without getting a preconceived idea in my head of what that section is about. So instead of the publisher putting the heading in, you have to go back and fill it in. And as I was reflecting on 2 Corinthians 10, a great question entered my mind, and that is, what do I measure the ministry God has given me by? What is the measuring stick for that ministry? In 2 Corinthians chapter 10, here in verse 12, it says this, "For we are not bold to class or compare ourselves with some of those who commend themselves, but when they measure themselves by themselves and compare themselves with themselves, they are without understanding." And so what is my measuring stick? What do I classify the ministry that I'm doing in Christ? What do I measure that by? How do I classify that ministry? As 2 Corinthians 13 says, "But we will not boast beyond our measure, but within the measure of the sphere which God apportioned to us as a measure to reach even as far as you." And so we have Paul here that's basically saying he measures it by the portioning that God has given to him. And so God apportions each a measure for ministry. God tells us how far we can go. God determines our ministry. Because in the end, the ministry doesn't belong to me. It is not my ministry. So many folks out there, and I know we're trying to use the best words possible, but we don't think through it. And a lot of pastors say, well, my ministry. In the end, it's not my ministry. I have no ownership or possession of it. No, it belongs solely to God. Two things that does. Number one, it takes a lot of pressure off me. For I am not the one who determines its success, but God is. And number two, then God leads me where I go. And that ministry becomes what God wants it to be and not what I want it to be. I have to follow the measure that God has given to me. Success is measured in America today, especially in the church, by numbers or by wealth. And I think we wrongly measure that success, especially in the church. Never once in the Old Testament or the New Testament was the success of Israel or the church ever measured by its number or by its finances. Never. In the end, what did God say? "I will make you the least of all nations, the star of my love." He uses the least of all things. And sure, at Pentecost, 3,000 were saved, and that's great. But that's not going to happen every single time in ministry. No, oftentimes ministry is the ministry of the small and not the large. So we need to get out of the idea of how we measure the success of ministry, especially here in America. But in the end, we also don't want to limit ourselves. So while we are successful and those things might come, big numbers in a congregation or great finances, those things may come, which is awesome. We just don't use those as a measuring stick. Those are what we call lagging indicators. Indicators that something is successful or that we're doing something right and God is blessing those things, which is great. But I've seen some of the smallest be blessed by some of the greatest of blessings. So let us measure according to God. Let us ask the questions, how spiritually mature are the people in my congregation? How well are we discipling one another? How are we growing relationships in God? And are we seeing success in people's relationships with God? But in a town of 1,500, it's sure harder to measure success by 3,000. Sometimes your resources are limited, but you can still be successful if we use the proper measuring tool that God gives us for ministry. So today, let us work within the sphere that God has given us to grow his ministry and his church. Grow the lost into relationship with him. Grow the confidence of people who have Christ in Christ, and grow the love for the church again. If we work inside our own sphere given to us, we will always be successful. But don't limit your sphere just based on your feelings, but let God lead you in that ministry, for God apportioned it to you, and God will make sure that you are successful. Thanks for joining me for just a sip and a little deeper look at the Word. God bless you.